famous David Gilmour band, which made more famous by Paul Davids. So it goes like this. Okay, so what I noticed watching Paul Davids' video was this. See this? This thing went like this. I was actually terrified by this because it's very painful. Right here, it hurts tremendously. Shouldn't do that. So the idea is that you have to rest the strings on the tip of your fingers to get a full control of your band, like this. You see, it's right there. So that's why you can, and you can play the long notes also and vibrate them. So I always do that when I need to control the band precisely, as opposite to something like this. That deliberately I put the neck string under the finger. Sort of Hendrix's. So in this case, it's perfectly under control. Another thing, I can change the position slightly and do it on the third string. And also I can check my pitch by doing unison bends like this. Unison bends give you chance to check your pitch. If you go out of pitch, it starts beating, vibrating. Here we go. This is too high. This is too low. This is perfect. Unison. And you can vibrate it too. Okay, so in this position I use the third string. That's my notes, target notes. Let's try impossible thing. So I'm reaching high E. So I'll play it. Third string. Can I reach F? Let's try. Quite a workout, you see. I'm using 10, 11, 15, 26, 36, 46 gauge on this guitar. So the third string is 15 gauge, which is nice. Here you go, that's the famous Paul Davis band, improved from this. To this. Thank you.